immigrants from Ireland, England, and Scotland brought the basic music styles that blended together to form what we now know as bluegrass music. Most of those people lived in the mountains, hills, or farm areas of the Appalachian region, which led to this music being known as mountain music. Bluegrass was able to be brought out of these regions through the invention of the phonograph in the early 1900s. Here we have Bill and Charlie Monroe. They were known as the Monroe Brothers and were one of the most popular acts in the 1920s. After Bill and Charlie split, Bill became known as the father of bluegrass with his group Bill Monroe and the Bluegrass Boys. Earl Skaggs joined the group in 1945 and helped develop the standard sound and instrumentation of a bluegrass band, which includes the banjo, the violin or fiddle, the guitar, the mandolin, and the upright bass. Let's listen to Fire on the Mountain by Bill Monroe and the Bluegrass Boys to hear their iconic sound. Monroe's group found great success at the Grand Ole Opry in Nashville. Here is an old photo of the Ryman Auditorium, where Bill often performed. This sign sits outside of the auditorium and commemorates the birthplace of bluegrass. Bluegrass became so popular that it was being used in television, such as the Bonnie and Clyde movie and the Beverly Hillbillies TV show. Despite its success in the movies, bluegrass did not attract large audiences through the 1960s. The invention of the Bluegrass Festival started to change that. The Nitty Gritty Dirt Band also helped introduce bluegrass music to pop music fans by using the sounds of bluegrass and featuring artists like Earl Skaggs on their songs, thus attracting a wider audience to music. Today, bluegrass festivals are still found all over the Appalachian region, and the music is enjoyed by fans of all ages.